Hey everybody, this is Brendan with Common Motor, common-motor.com on the internet, and welcome back to our troubleshooting electrical series. We're going to jump in and start testing a bunch of different components in the bike and show you how they work and how to troubleshoot each piece individually. We're going to do the horn right now, and the horn is a pretty simple circuit, but always it's good to reference your service manual and the wiring diagram for your specific bike, but they're all wired up pretty similar. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna explain the circuit of the horn. The second thing we're gonna do is we're actually gonna test the horn by itself to make sure it is working. And the third thing we're gonna do is test the circuit of the horn, which has its own three components, the ground, the 12 volt positive side, and the actual switching mechanism for the horn to turn it on. So this is going to be the circuit for the horn. Starting off with our charged battery. Negative is hooked to ground. Ground we know is the motor, the frame, handlebars, all the stuff is ground. When I hit this button here, the horn button, I'm connecting the button to ground. Through the button, runs a wire to the handlebars. It comes out right here. It's this light green wire, which connects directly to the horn. Through the horn, back to solid black, and we know solid black is 12 volt positive, and that ends up all the way back over here at the positive terminal of the battery. I'm gonna go ahead and unplug the horn from the circuit, so I'm gonna unplug the green wire and the solid black wire so the horn is isolated. I'm gonna use my jumper here, jumper wire, it's just an alligator clip. I'm gonna go to the black side wire here, make sure it doesn't touch anything else in the frame. And I'm gonna connect to the positive side of the battery. All right, be really careful in doing this. We know this is ground, so let's touch this to the engine and see the horn honks. Horn works. All right, we're gonna test the black wire, which we know is gonna be 12 volt positive back to the battery. I'm gonna turn on my key switch. Test light's hooked to ground. We're gonna touch that terminal there. Light kicks on. That means we have power from this point all the way back to positive side of the battery. So that side is good. We're gonna check the ground side of the circuit now. I'm gonna go ahead and hook my test light to the positive side of the battery with the alligator clip. I'm gonna come up to the handlebars, and I'm gonna touch it, the test light, kicks on. All right, that means we have ground connection from handlebars all the way to the negative side of the battery. The last piece we're gonna test is gonna be the circuit that actually controls the horn when we hit the button. So that's gonna be between this green, light green wire here and our black 12 volt positive. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my test light, I'm gonna grab it inside that black 12 volt positive there, making sure it doesn't touch anything else on the frame. I'm gonna take my test light, I'm gonna put it in the opposite terminal where the horn would have hooked, making contact, just like that. Turn my key on, I hit the button, see the light turns on. All right, there we are. Every time I hit the button, we connect the circuit, the light turns on, that says that circuit is good. All right, let's reconnect everything. I have the key off right now. The key on and make sure the horn works. Key's on, hit the button, horn works. With that, this has been Brendan with Common Motor, common-motor.com on the internet. Make sure you like and follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Subscribe to our newsletter via our website, and of course, subscribe to this YouTube channel down below, and don't forget to ring the bell, and we will see you next time.